sugar goes up, goes up, goes up, goes up, then it remains up. Not only that, today what has happened? We have been having what is called a thrifty gene. A gene which evolved millions of years ago, because in the forest, you're not assured of 3 meals a day or 5 meals a day. I already had 3 meals, that's why I'm saying that. And that kind of a thing was not there. You may get something today, you may not get for another day. So to do that, nature gave you two things. A, fat cells. It's like a bank locker. So you eat something extra on the day you get it, and something remains in the fat cells. On the bad days, it will come out. Today what happens, you get meals whether you like it or not, and you eat when you are not even hungry, and these fat cells get fed. And you don't need them at all. So you become very prosperous. Now we connect that with the disease. No, it's not the disease, it's the mind. That's all. So if you know that with the thrifty gene, you can't put yourself in a food plenty atmosphere. So the simple truth is, eat when you're hungry. Don't eat when you're not hungry. There's a Chinese couple, Irish couplet which says, I eat when I'm hungry, I drink when I'm thirsty. If heavens don't fall down, I'll certainly live till I die. You get that? Which we don't follow. And we have to follow that. Now we come back and see, what is this mind we talk about a lot? Swamiji gave me a book, Mind Body Medicine. That is what we used to think. That has all changed now. There is nothing called mind and body, two things. Mind is body, body is mind. You are your mind. Human mind is the human body as an illusion. Human body is an illusion. I close my eyes, you don't exist. I open my eyes, your vibrations, that's what's called in quantum physics, the wave collapse. It collapses into matter and you become matter because I can see you, a few photons leave you and hit my eyes and the photons leave, you are there. I close my eyes, our ministry is not there. Did you get that point? So, but the mind is always there. Your mind. Now I like the minister so much, that minister is in Timbuktu and I am here, we can communicate. You will be surprised. Mano Vega. Einstein was wrong. So sound is nothing. Light is nothing. This can go without loss of time from one place to another. That's called teleportation in quantum physics. Fascinating thing. We used to call it, our ancestors used to call it as telepathy. Supposing you want to talk, let us say, your daughter in California, somewhere. And intensely you want to talk to her, sincerely, not for cheating or something good. Either your daughter calls you or you call her or you get a message or an email or something like that within the next 10 minutes. And this is absolutely certain. That is teleportation. Supposing I pull out a gun, like the dum, dum, dum sound now. Now I'm standing here, you think BMI is a very nice man, you don't know I'm rascal inside, I pull a gun and say, oh, I'll shoot all of you. The second that I show you the gun, all your underwear are wet. Our conventional science used to say, the eye sees the gun, then it goes into the posterior association area, from there to the autonomic, the endocrine system, and down to the bladder, and the urine comes. It takes time, no? No, there is a mind in the urine bladder also. And there is a mind in every cell of the human body. How many cells are there?
53.
How much?
53 trillion.
Good. How did you exactly 53? About 50 to 100 trillion. Remember your one cell? That one cell became 100 trillion cells over the years. And mind you, it's a fascinating machine. I have not been able to understand a wee bit of that machine. I am amazed at the machine. What? How many things happen? My God. Millions of biochemical reactions occur every second. And so many complicated things happen. Who has done that? Which doctor did it? Now, do you think if something goes wrong, you require an MD, FRC, PFRC, SA, A, B, C, D, E, G to do that? No. Nature has provided a beautiful doctor inside. In every cell of yours, there's a doctor sitting there. He's a healer within. And that healer, we of course call in our Western language, in Latin, the immune system. So most of the time, if not all the time, your abnormalities are corrected by your own doctor. But everybody fails. except God, everyone fails. Everybody is fallible. Doctors are fallible. This doctor is also fallible. Sometimes he doesn't succeed. And then the body gives out a symptom. Says, okay, I have a headache. Remember, every symptom is important. Don't ignore a symptom. And then you must see a wise person who you call as a doctor. Doctor is not a qualified person. A wise person is called a doctor. And then get his advice. But the treatment part, you be a partner in that. You find out whether this treatment is good. Should I take it? If I don't take it, what will happen? What are the consequences? When once the patient becomes a partner, then only the treatment becomes sane. Otherwise, you dictate. You know, in the olden days, doctor, you're God, do what you like. Whatever you say, I'll take. That's a good thing for us because that faith cures it. Not the medicine. Medicine doesn't cure nobody. But the faith cures. But today, people have become internet savvy. They will ask the doctor, see, in the internet I saw it's like this. Don't believe in the internet. Don't read health books. Mark Twain wrote long back, quote, do not read health books. You may die of a misprint, unquote. Half knowledge is very dangerous. Either you must know everything or don't know nothing. And here is one area I tell you, the old saying of my grandmother, ignorance is bliss. I don't want to know about disease at all. The minute you read about a disease, now a lot of medical students, when they come and start reading a medical book in the beginning, muscle twitching, early sign of motor neuron disease. That's a sentence like that. So they start. Sir, motor neuron disease. What he has missed there is, a normal muscle twitching is normal, but a muscle which is completely wasted, if it twitches, it is motor neuron disease. That part he has left, the wasting, but sometimes he sees the wasting. If you imagine wasting, there is a wasting. And then he comes with motor neuron, because motor neuron disease has no treatment, so he says, okay, the end has come. He is so young, he doesn't want to die. People don't want to die, you know. I just console them. Dying, everybody should die. It's only cute. The only person who is born is die. I was even suggesting doctors instead of saying he's a pre-diabetic, he's a pre-hypertensive, he's a pre-cancer. Why all that trouble? You call everybody pre-death syndrome, pre-death. Everyone born has got death syndrome. So you're a pre-death syndrome. And have a medicine for that. That probably is the biggest selling medicine. Bigger than even statin, because it can be put into the water pipe for everybody to drink. So pre-death syndrome. All that is not necessary. Simply, when the symptom comes, find out what the symptom is like. A lot of people ignore their symptoms or self-treat them. Very dangerous. Or somebody asks his friend, he says, oh, my mother also had this and she took this tablet and I've got a few of it. I'll give it to you. Don't do that. Well, what the mother had and what you have may be totally different. Poles apart. Never ever take advice from people who don't. There are a lot of people giving free advice in India. We are so much interested in giving advice to others. Not doing good to others, but giving advice to others, which many times does more harm than good. And this kind of a medicine is practiced in India for centuries. So don't trust that part.